Hi and welcome! In today's video, you'll learn about the difference between personal data, demographics, and firmographics. Knowing these differences is not only knowing about nomenclature, because in the end this is not really what is important. What's important is the concept related to this type of data. So there are databases that, as I will discuss, are towards personal data, towards demographics, and there are databases that are focused on companies, and they are called firmographics. My name is Felipe, this is the Data Science Bits channel. Please subscribe and click on the bell button to receive notifications with every video that I post. And please don't forget to send comments, questions, it can be either through LinkedIn or YouTube. The first type of data that I will be discussing here is the personal data. The personal data is about the characteristics of the individuals. And usually this will be asked to a person in a form, either online or by letters or anything like that. And you will gather data around, for example, physical traits. So the color of the hair, the color of the skin, ethnicity. It can be related to income, the family's income, the personal monthly income. It can be related to the things that this person have. So for example, houses, apartments, cars, ships, helicopters, anything like that. You could gather data around that. There's another type of personal data that's the user data. So for applications and websites and softwares, you'll be collecting data about the specific users. And this user, of course, is a person. So it's also a type of personal data. So when you first have contact with a new database, the easiest way to identify the personal data is, of course, through the ID. The ID will be identifying each person. So there will be an user ID, a person's ID, or maybe in some countries you have unique identifiers that people have in that country. In the United States could be the social security number. In Brazil, for example, there's something called CPF. But also be aware that the tendency nowadays, especially in Brazil and Europe, is to anonymize that data. So you'll be using probably a hash that makes that person not identifiable. The second type of data that I want to discuss here is demographics. And demographics comes from the Greek demo, that's basically the people. This word has the same origins of the word democracy that I'm sure everyone knows. So demographics is the data about groups of people or populations. And you can have basically two types. Either you group people by, for example, religion or political alignment, or ethnicity, things like that. And it will describe the characteristics aggregated within those groups. The other type of demographics is when you restrict the groups by geography. Here in the United States, you have some popular ways to delimit geographies. The first one is by zip code, and you can have up to 5 digits zip codes to define certain regions. You can have districts or boroughs, then you can have cities, then counties, then states, and finally regions. And now that you have defined the type of geography that you are delimiting, you can aggregate data within that. So you will have, for example, median family income of each zip code and things like that. So as in the same way that we talked about in the personal data, there is an easy way to glance at a database and know that's about demographics, that this database is demographics data. And this is when you see that the unique key, the ID of your table, is a zip code, or maybe names of states, names of cities, things like that. You will be sure that's probably about demographics. But that type of ID will only tell you that the data is aggregated by different regions, and it's not telling you that's about people. To know that's about people, we'll have to look into each column to see what they are about. So for example, if there's income there, if there's ethnicity and things like that. Now we get to the final type of data that I want to discuss in this video. That's the third type of data, that's called firmographics. Firmographics comes from the Latin firmare. Firmare is to attest something, to sign something. And actually there is the word firm in English, and it refers to for-profit companies. So it's data about companies, basically. And there are two types of firmographics. The individual company data, individual company information, and the groups of companies are regionally aggregated data about companies. So examples of popular and common firmographics is basically contact information of the companies, so the telephone number, the address, the name of the place. This is the basic ones that you need to be in touch with these companies. Then you can go to the characteristics of the company. So for example, the square footage of the stores, or the number of employees. What are the partners of this company? Is it a public or a private company? And when you aggregate this data regionally, for example by zip codes, you start having insights about the types of business that are in a given region, the size of businesses in those regions, and this can be really useful. And the companies also can be groups of companies. So for example, you could have a chain, and the chain will have a headquarters, will have incorporated companies in different countries, and it will have different partners, different executives in different companies. And all this data that is basically a network of different people and different establishments that comprises a single company or a single group of companies. All this is also firmographics, so it can be quite complex. So now I will provide the same tips that I provide for the other data types. How to identify from a database that's about firmographics. So basically, you have an ID that in most cases will be called business ID, company ID, maybe chain ID, franchise ID, things that really take you to believe that this ID is related to a business. So in this case, it's about individual companies or groups of companies that many times are called chains. Or if you have the geography identifier, like a zip code, city, state, and the variables that you see in the table, you see that they are about companies, so number of employees, for example. You can know that this is firmographics data aggregated geographically. To conclude this video, I want to talk about the purpose of using these different types of data. So the most obvious purposes is if you have a business-to-consumer model. So you are, for example, a company that has application, website, softwares, and who uses this are people. So you have users. This, of course, will take you to use personal data on the user level, or you could use demographics. Now, if you have a business-to-business model or a business-to-business-to-consumer, of course, you'll be more interested in firmographics data because you're selling your product, your services to other companies. But also, if this other company is interested in consumers, probably you also want to know about demographics that are regional. Okay, so that's it. I hope you enjoyed. Please subscribe to the channel, follow me on LinkedIn, keep sending comments and questions. I'll keep bringing videos to provide clarification on nomenclature. I think nomenclature is not really what's really important, but we need to pay attention to the concepts. Because, as I said in this video, each type of database has a different purpose, right? So you need to know the different types and where to use them. I hope I'm bringing value to you with these videos, and if you really enjoy it, please hit the like button to support this channel. And see you in the next video.